Today, the hint is in the title of the campaign, Enough Food for Everyone If. We believe that there is enough food for everyone in the world, but tonight, 1 in 8 people are going to go to bed hungry. Not just peckish, but hungry, seriously hungry. And we believe that it doesn't have to be like that. We know it doesn't have to be like that. And that there is enough food for everyone. But if, that word is so important. And we have 4 big ifs as a campaign that we're taking to David Cameron and the other G8 leaders today and over the next 10 days here in London and also in Belfast next weekend. We want to be able to ask the G8 to take seriously their commitments on aid, because one of the reasons why there isn't enough food is because people are not able to grow the right amount of food, be able to tackle the kind of issues around having the right crops and tackle climate change, for instance, that makes it very much more difficult to grow crops. The second issue is about tax and about the kind of revenue that's available. At Christian Aid, as part of one of the important IF, one of the IF's members of the IF coalition, we've been doing some work around tax for quite a long time, and tax is one of the 4 key elements of our asks. We estimate that $160 billion a year of money is lost to developing countries through tax dodging. Now that money could go into food, it could go into education, could go into healthcare, all those sorts of things, but that's the kind of scale of the whole that we need. So the reason why tax is the second issue that we're talking to the G8 leaders about is because that's a really important sustainable source of revenue that can help countries feed their own people. The third issue is about land. Land is essential to grow food, but things like land grabs and the way in which land is used to grow biofuels rather than food, that's an issue that needs to be tackled. And fourthly, we've got to shine a light of transparency on the activities of governments and of companies as well, in terms of their behaviours, in terms of the way in which they're really able to be held accountable by their people. We believe that if you get these 4 things right, aid, land, tax and transparency, that will go a very, very significant way to tackling why there's 1 in 8 people that will go to bed hungry tonight. Well, this morning David Cameron's hosting a nutrition summit, so we're hoping for some real significant pledges around tackling nutrition in terms of giving money. We're hoping for an agreement, a convention on transparency, around a convention on tax, particularly around exchanging of information. We're hoping for some sort of a moratorium around land grabs, and we're hoping for an agreement on a kind of transparency convention too. So we've got real significant asks on all of those 4 things. We might not get them all, but we think it's really important to be raising that bar high and making sure that the government knows that we're looking at them, we're holding them to account, and we're going to want to know what they're doing. Well, Christian Aid believes that we need to be able to tackle the structural causes of poverty. We work through partners around the world, about 45 different countries, to help build their ability to be able to work long term. Sometimes that's helping farmers to be able to kind of diversify their crops, sometimes it's solar powered fridges, sometimes it's all sorts of different things. But fundamentally it's about the long term answers, not immediate kind of delivery. We obviously have a humanitarian programme that provides need where it's needed in the instance, but for the main part of our development programme, it is about working, but particularly with vulnerable groups and women in particular, to be able to help them take long term stands for development.